Hello everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to discuss about how to prioritize test and disable tests in TestNG. So let's start with this. So first of all, prioritizing the test. So normally when I create our test methods in the TestNG class, will be executed in alphabetical order. So that is the default behavior of TestNG. But how we can prioritize them? Suppose if you want to execute those test methods in my particular order, so how we can prioritize them? So we'll see practically. So let me open my IntelliJ IDE. So here under SRC, I'm going to create new TestNG test case. So take the new Java class, and here I'll give name as priority example, then okay. So now I created a new TestNG class, and here I'll create few test methods. So first of all, I'll create void, let's say test one, and here I will write a small message. Just hold on. Right, so in the test one, I'll create a simple message. Let's say this is one test method within the test case. So system.out.println. Here I'll say this is test one. And I will mention this as @ test annotation, because TestNG will consider this method as a test method if you specify the @ test annotation. Similarly, I will also create few more tests. Let's say void test two. Inside this, I will create another method. So this is test two. And I will specify this also @ test annotation. Similarly, let's create one more test. Let's say test three, and this is a test three. And finally, I will create one more test method. Let's say test four, and this is your four. So currently I have four test cases or four test methods inside the test case. So let's execute this test case as TestNG. So run priority example. Now all the four test methods will execute. Now you can see here, you can see the output here. In which order it is executed is, first test four is executed, test one, three, and two is executed. So this is an output I got. So first four is executed, then one, three, two is randomly it is executed, right? So by default, the TestNG will follow the alphabetical order. So that's the reason we got the output in different order. But in the real scenario, on real case, right, suppose if I have implemented here is open application, or here I have implemented login, and in another method I have implemented logout. So in this case, we have to follow the proper sequence, right? So how it is possible? So we can prioritize this test methods. So by adding the priority, one of the parameter for annotations, we can execute these test methods in proper order. So how we can prioritize these methods? So we can pass a parameter called priority. So I can just give priority anything. I can say zero, I can start from zero. And similarly, I can provide priority for every test method. I'll say here one, and for here I can say two, and here I will say three, and here I can say, okay, three. So totally we have a three methods. So when I give the priority numbers, right, it should be a proper order. So it can, you don't need to give like 1, 0, 2 like this. You can also give 10 here, 20, 30, 40. So something like this, but whichever number comes first, that particular method will execute. So also you can give some random numbers. Like here you can say 1, here you can say 5, or here you can say 20, here you can say 100, if you have more methods. So we can also give these numbers in random order. So there is no rule like we have to give only sequential numbers. We don't require that. So we can just give any number, but whichever number comes first, that particular method will execute first. So now I have added the priority for the test. So now let us execute this, run as priority example. So let me run this one. So save it and just run priority example. Now we can see the test methods have executed in proper order based on the priority. Now you can see test one, test two, three, and four is executed. So I'm able to execute all the tests in proper order by adding the priority. So now, for example, I haven't completed certain method. So let us say some method is not yet completed, still it is progress. So at, when I execute this, my class, right, or test, all methods by default executing, right? But I want to disable certain test methods. Suppose I have 1 to 4 test methods. I don't want to execute fourth one because still it is in progress, not yet completed. So what I can do is I can just disable this method. So how to disable this method? I can add one more parameter here, that is enable is equal to false. I have to make this parameter is false. So when I make this priority enable is equal to false, then this method will not participate in the execution at runtime. So by default, enable property will be true. So that's the reason TestNG will execute this method. But when I make this enable property false, then this method will not be executed at the runtime. Now let us execute, run, save this method, and right click, run priority example. Now you can see, now somewhere it is getting error. Okay, so let me add, save it. Special characters are added. So now let me execute again. All right, so now once you got that output, okay, let me execute one more time. I think window is gone. Just a moment. All right, so now let me execute one more time. So run priority example, sorry. Yeah. Okay, let me run one more time. So here I can just save the file and run priority example. Now you can see all the test methods are executed except test3 method, right? So because we have enable, we can make this enable property is false and then it is not participated in the execution, right? So this is how we can just make our test methods disabled. So this is a one of the feature we have in testing. So prioritizing the test by adding priority parameter and disabling the test by adding enable parameter as false. So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.